Hi, this is Trip and welcome to my channel. Hope you will subscribe and please click the bell to be notified of future videos. Maybe you'll like the video and feel free to comment, share with others. Today we're talking about the Burger King Impossible Whopper. I wanted to get out there yesterday and review this, but life intervened and I just didn't make it. So I'm a day late. Ooh, I have it right here. I'll talk about it a little bit, just keep it kind of warm while I'm going on about it. I have some notes here. This is a 100% Whopper, 0% beef. And that sounds like it's too good to be true, and it probably is. I mean, that part of it, I believe. It's all plant-based. But a TV talking here this morning was saying that it really wasn't so healthy as you think it might be. Burger King is taking the plant-based Impossible Whopper. It took it nationwide yesterday. The 8th, I guess that was. You see, I have my ticket here from Burger King. Yeah, today is the 9th. So it went nationwide yesterday. And here's the way they describe it. The Burger King tells me, our Impossible Whopper sandwich features a savory flame-grilled patty made from plants topped with juicy tomatoes, fresh lettuce, creamy mayonnaise, ketchup, crunchy pickles, and sliced white onions on a soft sesame seed bun. 100% Whopper, 0% beef. End of quote. Well, good enough on that. But right off the bat, I'm going to trim this down a little bit. I'm not going to have any creamy mayonnaise or any ketchup. And it doesn't come with cheese, apparently, which is good because I would not have the cheese either. You know, these kind of ingredients really just muck everything, and you can't really tell what it truly tastes like. Look at all the napkins they gave me. You think I have enough napkins? I'm not that nasty. Get some mustard. I don't like a lot of goo on anything, but I do like a little mustard. It adds a little flavor to it. By the way, I got there at about, they start serving at 10:30. All the Burger Kings here do. And I was about maybe like 10:15. And I just asked about it, and they said, yeah, we'll fix it for you. So that was very nice of them. Thank you, Burger King. So here, very nice and colorful. I believe all the Whoppers around the U.S. were in the same kind of packaging here. Now, normally I would put this on one of my fine china to eat. So what should I do? Shall I? No, I don't guess so. No, I'm not really going to do that. Okay. Too much going on here. This table is very busy. Let's check it out. If it has mayonnaise or ketchup or what else, or cheese, I'll be upset. There. Looks okay to me. a sign of mayonnaise. We have our, there's the lettuce. You can just see the pickles over there. Hope there are onions. I mean, yeah, there's onions, good. Where are the pickles? No, I don't see any. Oh, here they are. There are the pickles. Can you see them there? Can you, dear? Okay. Let's put this back up here like this now. I use one of these mini napkins that they gave me instead of my unusual, one of my colorful napkins here. Let's cut through the middle of it here, and you can see a bit of cross-section of it, I think. I'm just going to eat this on the wrapper they provided. I've never done that before. I always use the fine china. But I won't do that today. We'll take away from the, you know, the big picture. So. There's the cross section. See, the meat looks just like the regular Whopper, doesn't it? It's got your sesame seed bun, okay. And we already discovered that it has that it has pickles, onions, and lettuce. So now I'll make sure I warm that up and have that too later. I'm going to put a little mustard on here. Mustard is not as unhealthy either as having a bunch of ketchup and mayonnaise. When I finish this, I'll speak more in depth about the Whopper. The Impossible Whopper, I mean. Okay. Very important day. Okay, so far so good. Taste the onion and the pickles and the tomato. See, if you put a bunch of gunk on your food, you can't taste the natural food. How can you do a review of something if it's covered with a bunch of stuff on it? You need to keep it to the basics. I mean, lettuce is good, and tomatoes, and onions, pickles, that's all good. Pickles taste good. The lettuce is very fresh. Tomato seems fresh. It's kind of hard to tell. I think it is. has that charbroiled taste. So far, I'm pretty well impressed with it. I think it's very similar to the traditional Whopper. It tastes like a hamburger to me. Take a look at that meat again. I'm going to let you see it right here in the piece I've divided. Check that out. It has that charbroiled kind of taste to it. Tell you here. Right, this is for a limited time only. And this meatless and vegan burger, I think it ends in September, this Impossible Whopper. But I'm not sure. It is available for delivery through the Burger King app. And I guess it is pronounced vegan. Some people pronounce it vegan or vegan, but really I think vegan is the proper way. And this appeals not just to Whopper fans, but also to vegan fans. Because it's... Oh, one thing though, just because it's purely plant-based does not mean it... They cook it on... They normally will cook it on the same grill where they were cooking burgers and chickens and so forth. I think you might can request it to be cooked on a different grill. I'm not sure. And they were the first, Burger King was the first fast food place to offer this plant-based patty. It came from Impossible Foods, which is another company, and they make the Impossible Patty. The Impossible Whopper will have they suggest $5.59, and that's exactly what I paid, $5.59 plus tax. The burger was made to taste exactly like the original Whopper. And they're going to monitor it and see how successful it is and consider adding it as a permanent Burger King part of the menu, a staple product. First, they ran a test in St. Louis, Missouri, and it increased sales a lot there, so they put it out nationwide yesterday, August 8th. Only about 5% of all Americans consider themselves vegetarians, and that hasn't changed much over the years. So to make this product successful, it would have to depend on other people too liking it, not just vegans. They also, according to the press release, they say it's also environmentally friendly. The product reduces the use of land, water, and greenhouse emissions. What else can I tell you? If there's too much demand for this, then they expect there could be a supply shortage. So they're working around the clock to make sure that you get your Impossible Whopper. Nutrition. Don't think this is a purely healthy burger. It has 630 calories, which is good for me, since at my doctor's appointment yesterday, I discovered I weighed 99 pounds. I've lost a pound. It has 11 grams of saturated fat. Cholesterol 10 milligrams, not too bad. A lot of sodium, 1,080 milligrams. Okay, protein, that's good, 25 grams. Remember, you can reduce the impact of this on your health, on your body, if you don't. These nutrition numbers I gave you, it is the fully packed burger that includes the mayonnaise and the ketchup and everything else. So you can reduce that kind of substantially. You know, you can move the needle a little bit, a few percentage down, if you just don't have a slock on a bunch of mayonnaise and ketchup. And that pretty much concludes my review for the day. The Impossible Whopper from Burger King. Oh, and this has nothing to do with it, but yesterday, August the 8th, was the 50th anniversary of, in 1969, when the Beatles crossed the street at Abbey Road on the Abbey Road album. You can see them all four walking like that. And that was on the news yesterday. Well, when I went to Europe in 73 as a poor student backpacking with no money, I did manage to get to London, stayed there for a few days, and I went out to Abbey Road. Being a musician, I mean, the Beatles were, the Beatles are yet. And I crossed at the same place where the Beatles crossed at, but there was no one to take an iconic photo of me, because I was by myself. I threw that in for free. This is Tripp, and I'm wishing you the best. I'm seeing how this Bluetooth thing here works. I just learned how to do that, I think. Let's see if it works.